What if I told you that there is a snail living at the bottom of the Indian Ocean that is made out of iron? Well, that is exactly the story of the scaly-foot snail, and today we're going to be diving into this insane creature, the environment it calls home, and some of the mystery that still surrounds its biology. I'm Ned, a science storyteller. Thanks for tuning into The Curious Current, and consider subscribing if you're interested in learning more about the ocean and all the mysteries beneath the waves. The scaly-foot snail, or Chrysomalyn squamiferum, is one of the weirdest, toughest animals on the planet. It lives on hydrothermal vent fields over 2,000 meters deep in the Indian Ocean, where scalding hot fluids pour out of cracks in the seafloor, rich with metals and sulfides. Instead of saying no thanks to that extreme environment, the scaly-foot snail said yes please and turned it into a home and a fashion statement. Its foot is covered in hard, overlapping scales made of pyrite, aka fool's gold, and greigite, a magnetic iron sulfide also found in compass needles. This snail isn't just surviving, it's cosplaying a medieval knight. But that's not all. This snail shell is a biological marvel. It's made of three layers. A top layer of iron sulfide plates, think armor plating. A middle layer of organic cushion, basically a shock absorber, and a bottom layer of aragonite, which is a calcium-based mineral also found in pearls. Together, this tri-layer design makes the shell incredibly resistant to crushing forces, temperature swings, and even predatory attacks. Engineers have studied this structure for developing better armor and flexible ceramics. This is called biomimicry. If you're interested in learning more about biomimicry, I've already put out a video on the subject. You can see it in the video here. Go ahead and follow that if you're interested in learning more. So yeah, this tiny snail is basically influencing military-grade tech while we're still trying to remember where we left our keys. To understand how the scaly-foot snail became so extra, you've got to understand its world. Hydrothermal vents are like underwater volcano chimneys, and hotter than your shower on its angriest setting. But somehow it's teeming with life. No sunlight means no photosynthesis. So everything here runs on chemosynthesis, a process where bacteria use chemicals like hydrogen sulfide to make energy. The scaly-foot snail takes this a step further. Its esophagus houses special bacteria that live inside its own body, turning those chemicals into nutrients. It's like carrying a private power plant in your gut or in your throat. Move over probiotics. This is symbiosis turned up to 11. Let's dive into the science of extremophiles. This snail isn't just a curiosity, it's a biological blueprint for surviving extreme conditions. Studying creatures like this helps us understand how life might exist on other planets, like the icy moons Europa, which may have deep ocean vents of their own. They also teach us about biomineralization, how organisms build hard structures, and how symbiosis can drive evolution in wild directions. It's the kind of discovery that makes you realize, the more we explore, the weirder and more wonderful life becomes. These deep sea vent fields are now being targeted for deep sea mining, a growing industry that wants to extract rare metals from the seafloor. And guess what sits right on top of these precious minerals? Yep, creatures like the scaly-foot snail. Entire ecosystems that have existed for millions of years could be wiped out before we even finish cataloging them. In fact, the scaly-foot snail was the first deep-sea species to be listed as endangered. Not because it's being hunted, but because its home might be destroyed. The scaly-foot snail reminds us that life finds a way, even in the harshest, darkest corners of our world. But it's up for us to decide whether we'll protect that wonder or mine it out of existence. If this strange little snail taught you something today, share it, talk about it, ask questions. The more people who know about life in the deep, the more likely we are to keep it alive. This is Ned, reminding you to stay curious and stay current. Thank you for watching.